This is a continuation of molecular orbital theory. In the previous lecture, I explained sigma, pi and delta bonds. Over here, you can see that in case of sigma bonds and pi bonds, there are two types of orbitals formed in each case. SA and SB combine to give one sigma G and one sigma U star. That is one bonding orbital and one antibonding orbital. The bonding orbital is represented as sigma G, which is a sigma orbital which is gerade, and the antibonding orbital is sigma U star, that is, it is ungerade. The meaning of gerade and ungerade is, if a orbital is gerade, it means that when it is reflected through the center of symmetry, it does not change its sign. And in case of ungerade, if it is reflected through its center of symmetry, it changes its sign. So in case of sigma orbitals, the bonding orbital is gerade and the antibonding orbital is ungerade. But in case of pi orbitals, the bonding orbital is ungerade and the antibonding orbital is gerade. So over here, SS overlap has been represented. The plus leads to bonding orbital and the minus leads to a higher energy antibonding orbital. Over here, PP, sigma overlap has been represented, leading to a bonding orbital which is represented by sigma G and an antibonding orbital. And over here, pi orbital has been shown, leading to a pi U, which is the ungerade bonding pi orbital, and the minus leads to pi G star, which is the antibonding gerade pi orbital. So these are the different types of overlap and the orbitals formed. Now moving on to the actual molecular orbital diagrams that we need to know. So this is the molecular orbital diagram of oxygen. As you can see, 1s has not been represented. Why? Because it is considered to be an inner orbital. That is, those electrons don't participate in any chemical reaction, so they are not considered. So we'll only consider 2s and 2p. An oxygen atom has 8 electrons. So if we don't consider the 2 electrons which are in 1s, that leaves us with 6 electrons. So there, if we have 6 electrons from each oxygen atom, here see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and over here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So total of 12 electrons. These 2s orbitals combine to form one bonding orbital, which can be written as sigma 2s or sigma or 2 sigma g. Why 2 sigma g? Because 1s orbitals had also combined to form 2 sigma orbitals, which were called 1 sigma g and 1 sigma u. So over here, these 2 electrons and these 2 electrons get filled up here, and the 2p undergoes sigma overlap as well as pi overlap. So when there is sigma overlap, it leads to these two orbitals, and when there's pi overlap, it leads to these two orbitals. As you can see, the spacing in case of sigma is greater than the splitting in case of pi. Why is that so? That is so because of the fact that in case of sigma, the overlap is much greater. Whenever the overlap is greater, the splitting of the bonding and antibonding is also greater. So the next question is, how do we know that this is the molecular orbital diagram which is accurate? We know it is accurate because of the fact that oxygen is found to be experimentally paramagnetic. If this was not the order of molecular orbitals, that is, if this sigma orbital was below, then these two electrons would have been paired, and then overall the molecule would not have been paramagnetic. So this energy level diagram is understandable. The other energy level diagram that we need to understand is the diagram for boron. As you can see over here, there's no problem with the 2s. The electrons are filled here. Over here you can see that these two orbitals have interchanged. So why have they interchanged? These two have not interchanged. These two have interchanged. So why have they interchanged? They have interchanged because of a phenomenon called sp mixing. what happens is, till nitrogen, the s and the p orbitals are sufficiently energetically close so that they can undergo overlap. So what happens is, these two orbitals, this orbital gets destabilized and this orbital gets stabilized, as a result of which the energy level of these two set of orbitals get interchanged. So see, in oxygen the pi was here and the sigma was there, and the sigma was here and the pi was here. So the order was sigma the most splitted and the pi like this. And in case of boron, the pi is here, then the sigma, then the pi, then the sigma. So basically these two are fine, these two have just got interchanged. Here again, how do we know that this is the correct energy level diagram? We know that because of the fact that this molecule is found to be again paramagnetic. If this was not the ordering, if this was below this, then the two electrons would have been paired up in this orbital. And then in that case, overall, the molecule would have not been paramagnetic, it would have been diamagnetic. So till nitrogen, this is the order of energy levels. This is the energy level order for the molecular orbitals. And after nitrogen, that is from oxygen, this is the order of molecular orbitals.